grande y grande sueño.
Okay. Yeah, so you're gonna go to me first, and then once I introduce them, you open it.
Okay. Yeah.
Gracias por estar con nosotros una vez más. Aquí ya tenemos a nuestros invitados, a Nico Sotolongo y Sara Molina. Ramírez Molina. Ok, que están, nos van a hablar ahorita del proyecto que estamos trabajando, que se llama Da Cucuy o El Cucuy, o El Coco, como le dicen en muchos países. Ya también estamos en el Facebook Live, estamos en la Cámara Internacional, así que muchas gracias por acompañarnos. Gracias por estar con nosotros, muchachos. Él es mi director, Nico Sotolongo, y como les digo, es la productora ejecutiva, Sara Ramírez Molina. Thank you so much, guys, for listening to us. We have here in the studio Nico Sotolongo and Sara Ramirez Molina, she's the executive producer, and he's the director of the project that we are working on that is called El Cucuy. So tell us, Nico, a little bit about the story and the project, how you come up with it, and what you expect from it, and what do you think about the film, and are you excited?
I'm very excited, yeah. I have my star. And our actors are cast. The name of the film is Cucuy. It's something I grew up with. You know, it was lived in our basement. It was in the laundry room. And if you didn't run past and hit the light real quick, you're going to get eaten. So I came up with the idea to write the film based on some of the stuff that we're dealing with here in America right now. There was a young girl in L.A. whose parents were taken from her by ICE, and they left her at the game with no way to get home, and that just really affected me. And so I thought, you know, let's tell a story through an immigrant family's eyes. And so Cucuy is about Carmen and Hector, who are a migrant family living on a small farm. And, you know, Hector's just a young little boy, and Carmen kind of tries to get him to eat his dinner and go about doing the things she has to do to get him ready for bed. She tells him the story of the Cucuy, which is the boogeyman, to kind of get him to listen to her and do what she wants him to do, thinking it's just a story. And then we slowly find out that there is something actually coming after them in their house. And it's a horror thriller, and there's a bit of a twist ending, but yeah, it's the most of the story. So what else did you ask?
Well, just tell us, like, what exactly this means to you, and why do you decide to have this project as your thesis for the university?
At our school, University of Colorado Denver, they try to tell stories that are personal to you, that mean something. Oh. I'm the first generation American in my family. My dad's from Cuba. My mom's from Holland. You know, I'm lucky that I kind of blend in a little bit, and my Spanish is very bad. But
very true. We didn't correct anything on the script, nothing at all.
They've rewritten the whole thing for me. So, but yeah, it's just, doesn't matter what you look like. America is a country of immigrants. It's important that we, especially right now with the current president and the administration as we're dealing with, to tell stories from other perspectives. And this is a story from a very vulnerable perspective and of people right now who need help and need their voices to be heard a little bit. And as an immigrant's, you know, son, that's important to me, and I wanted to stand up and do something, even a small little thing like telling a short film, that's important. And I think every little step helps towards making people realize that, you know, everyone in this country who comes here, there's no such thing as illegals or immigrants. We kind of classify people as something lesser than. We're all people.
Yes.
And it's important. This is a country built by immigrants, and it's important that we look at them not as this thing. No, they're people. This is a mother and a son, and that's the story I'm trying to tell.
Just like families, like everyone else. It's mm-hmm. not, you know, that we're not any different. You know, there's good and bad in every culture, and I think, you know, that somehow some people have categorized us as that we just came and took advantage of the benefits and things mm-hmm. like that in this country when reality is that the most of us, you know, and especially people that they're, you know, undocumented, I guess, let's call it like that, they don't even get their taxes back. You know, so they're working and working and they're paying taxes and they are not getting the money back. So it's actually like they're giving a lot of money to this country and to people that are actually taking benefits from the country is their money as well. So for them to say like there's a lot of us taking advantage, I don't think is correct, you know, but I don't think it's our culture is the only one that sometimes, you know, ask for help to the government. And I think that's in every single culture. So these films, when I read the script, like hit me hard, you know, like I came from Mexico too, and actually I came as illegal. So I'm a citizen now, you know, because I worked really hard, you know, and I didn't want to stay as illegal. I didn't want to stay as, you know, being afraid of anything happening to me. And then if I had a family, you know, what's going to happen to that family if I don't, you know, move on or if I don't succeed, you know? So that's what moved me, you know, and seeing my dad, how hard he worked to, you know, bring us to this country and to, for us to see us, you know, like me and somebody, I was like, I'm going to do this more for my dad, you know? And then I thought, oh, my family, I was like, okay, you know, if I have a family, I do want them to be comfortable with, like, okay, my mom is not going to be taken back to Mexico, you know? And unfortunately, there's a lot of people in any culture that they don't want to go and get their papers, you know, because they think that they have a lot of rights, you know, here, and they don't need them. But on a way, I think, you know, we all need to understand there's rules to every country. You know, we need to speak the language of the country that we're living in. And help our family like that. You know, if you don't do that, then you kind of stay behind. Mm-hmm. So I really like this, you know, where this family is really working hard, you know, and they're having the son, you know, trying to make them understand the American culture, the United States culture. And it really was really nice for me to be part of this. And also my son, that is going to play my son. Unfortunately, he was not here because he was still sleeping.
It was brilliant casting on our part. That was just
yeah, so I thank you guys for taking us in consideration and working with us. And tell us when we start filming and what is going to be like filming with you guys and this place.
A nightmare. It's going to be terrible.
But it's going to be food, right?
Yeah, lots of food.
Otherwise, our food, we're going to spend a nightmare. Yeah, it's all good.
We shoot November 7th through the 10th at the Bromley Farms in Brighton. It's a historic farmhouse. It's gorgeous cornfields and just great rooms. It was built in 1870s, I think. It's just really incredible. But it's going to be a little cold, so we'll have to prepare. But it's going to be 4-night shoots, and it's a horror film, so it's important to build that kind of chemistry and really add to it. And
This is one of the larger crews we've worked with because we have been really committed to the quality of the film overall, I think. Student films in general can sometimes suffer from being kind of haphazardly thrown together, but Nico's been working on this for months now, and he brought me on at the very beginning of the semester, so we've been working on it for a few months now together. And we're really excited. It's a big, big project. We have a lot of people to manage. We have a massive location to take care of, but we think it's going to be great, and hopefully that will definitely show in the final product.
Mm-hmm. So, Nico, you're saving a lot of money for the food, right? This is a big crew.
All
and
the
I
budget.
Eat a lot.
Well, my mom's cooking, so that's good. We're going to get some
No, grandma. Grandma's coming. Grandma's cooking. Yeah. But no, but that is really awesome. You know, I'm really excited to start working and to start filming. And like I said, I've been, you know, kind of playing and rehearsing with my son, you know, and I think he's understanding a little bit more of what I'm, you know, what I tell him sometimes, like, you know, this is what we're doing this, you know, this is why, you know, a lot of immigrants are fighting for. And I think it's getting more into him, you know, to learn more of this stuff. So that's really cool. And Sarah, ¿nos puedes decir en español cómo es que empezaste en este proyecto? ¿Cómo es que conociste a Nico? Y ¿qué es lo que piensas tú del proyecto? Y cómo te llega a ti.
Pues Nico y yo nos conocimos hace 3 años en la universidad, porque estamos en el mismo programa de cine en la Universidad de Colorado Denver. Y al principio de ese semestre de otoño, él me preguntó si quería ser la productora en su proyecto final, su tesis de cuarto año. Le dije que sí, por supuesto que sería una oportunidad muy padre, porque él tiene una reputación de hacer unos filmes muy ambiciosos, unos proyectos grandes que en verdad involucran a mucha gente, que tienen temas muy interesantes. No son cosas pequeñas como muchos tenemos el deseo de hacer, porque tenemos muchas limitaciones, pero siempre...
Así cosas rápido y que casi todo el mundo hace, pero leí también que tiene muchos, ha ganado premios por
eso. Sí, ha ganado premios por su trabajo, también ha trabajado profesionalmente con Vice y cosas así como entrenado y asistente. Y cuando empezamos a hablar, por la primera vez hablamos de ese proyecto en la primavera, porque me preguntó que si tal vez me gustaría ayudarlo a traducir algunas cosas. Pero luego decidió mantener la mayoría del proyecto en inglés, con muy pocas líneas en español, y entonces él escribió el guión solo. Luego, al principio del semestre, en agosto, empezamos a trabajar yo como productor y él como director. Y lo que me gustó mucho de este proyecto es que es tan pertinente al momento en que estamos viviendo, que tenemos un presidente que desafortunadamente está tachando a muchísima gente que son trabajadores, que son honestos, de criminales, gente mala. Y también en las noticias, cuando oímos de inmigrantes, de ilegales, de indocumentados, no oímos personas, humanos, mamás, papás, hijos. Y este proyecto lidia con el temor y el horror de un pequeño al perder sus padres por su estatus migratorio. Y es una historia de humanos, es una historia de familia. Y no nada más no es un documental, no es un noticiero, es una historia de un pequeño y de sus padres y del horror que esta situación le causa y de los sentimientos y la emoción que él tiene que sentir en ese momento, que muchas veces se nos olvida cuando hablamos de este caso o estos problemas. Se nos olvida hablar de la gente.
Exacto. Y también muchas veces nomás oímos que cierta persona indocumentada fue deportada a su país, pero nunca oímos a quién deja y o qué es lo que esa persona estaba haciendo cuando lo agarraron. Hay veces que sí dicen que se estaba trabajando. Ok, estaba trabajando. ¿Cuál era su récord criminal? No tiene ningún récord criminal. Estoy de acuerdo cuando dicen, ok, vamos a deportar a toda la gente que tiene récord criminal. Ok, pero ahorita la mayoría de los que se están siendo deportados son gente que está trabajando, que está saliendo adelante por su familia, no tiene ningún récord criminal, ni siquiera un accidente de tráfico, ni nada de eso. Y eso es muy importante de este filme, que van a ver el proceso o el sufrimiento que pasa una familia al perder parte de ella, ¿verdad? Y dinos, ¿también vas a estar ahí en el set para cuando estamos filmando?
Sí, los 4 días voy a estar ahí. Vamos a estar, como dijimos, tenemos muchísima gente trabajando con nosotros porque es un proyecto muy grande y ambicioso. Entonces yo voy a estar ahí. También tengo un coproductor que va a estar en el set los 4 días para asegurarnos que todo esté bien, que todos tengan lo que necesitan y que podamos ejercer este proyecto lo mejor que podamos.
No, pues qué bueno. Y sé que tienen una página para recaudar fondos para el filme. Si gustan apoyarnos, porque como es un proyecto grande, es un proyecto ambicioso, pues se necesita de mucho dinero. Entonces, entre más fondos haya, pues es mejor, la mejor calidad y todo eso que puede ser este filme. Porque también tengo entendido que quieren pasarlo a festivales.
Uh-huh. Sí, queremos pasarlo a festivales. Hay muchos festivales, por ejemplo, de aquí de Denver y todo alrededor del mundo que aceptan proyectos de este tamaño. Y queremos que la mayor audiencia lo pueda ver, que la mayor gente lo pueda ver para sacar ese mensaje y para que entiendan esas historias. Y es lo que estamos tratando de enseñar.
¿Y cuál es la página de nos?
Tenemos una página en GoFundMe, si quieres decir el nombre de la página.
I think it is kind of long.
It is long. We have the link. Yeah, we sent the link so we can put that up later. And we'll have a video by the end of this week because I had an older one that didn't look as good. So we'll do a better one with some of our production crew and location pictures and stuff. So yeah.
Okay, so there you guys have it. We're gonna share the link. I'm gonna put it on KUH's Denver Facebook page, also on my page. And you know, if you guys wanna friend you guys on Facebook, you know, what's your Facebook page?
My Facebook page, we have it's at Kukui. As the page, but we'll do our
that's
personal.
The official,
that's the official official
film.
Page.
Yeah. Okay. And then you can friend Nico.
Nico Sotolongo at Facebook.
Can you say your name in Spanish?
Nico Marley Sotolongo.
Hey, good job. But yeah, so send me that page as well, and I'll be sharing it with everybody. And hopefully there are some of you guys that wanted to support this project and help us out. And I don't know what they have, like, how you call it, like kudos and stuff like that if they when they donate or.
So with the GoFundMe, we're trying to raise the money to put just basic production costs into consideration, and then later we're trying to do we'll do digital releases of the final film. The problem is with festivals, they make you show first, and then you can send them out to people. So it'd be after we get into some festivals, but we'll do a digital copy, and I think we might try to make some T-shirts that are kind of cool. So we'll see how far we can go with that.
Yeah, and the funding would also help us get into the festivals because most of them have...
They charge the fee. That is true.
I totally forgot about that.
Yeah. And also, so don't be impatient. The films, sometimes it takes a while, so... Not to the post-production or anything like that, but that takes a long time too. But as far as like sending the digital copy, all the films have to be showing the film, and then that's when we can release it or we can show you guys more of it. So there's the page. No se les olvide. Si gustan apoyarnos en este filme, vamos a estar compartiendo una página que se llama GoFundMe, y el link se lo vamos a estar proviendo ahí en el Facebook. Es para que nos apoyen a recaudar fondos para hacer mejor la producción y para entrar a festivales. Van a poner la película en festivales alrededor del mundo, así que, y muchos de esos festivales pues cobran para ponerla, para mandarla, o sea, que sea de perdida una opción, así que no se les olvide, vamos a estarla compartiendo en las páginas, y la página del Facebook de la película es At Cucuy, you said it was?
So, yeah, we have Facebook our page. Facebook page, At Cucuy, and then we'll put up a better one that's more inclusive with all the upcoming show times and dates, anything we get going.
Okay, so I'll be sharing that one too. So if you guys would like to like it, that will be great, because you know that will tell us how many people are actually, you know, waiting for it and supporting us. So don't forget about that. Is there anything else that you guys would like to add?
We will be premiering in May at Cinefest, which is the film festival for the University of Colorado Denver. That's where we showcase all of our films. Mm-hmm. So that'll be the first opportunity for everybody to view it.
Okay, and is that charge? Is there a fee for it? Or?
No, it's free to the public. It's first come, first serve basis. It's usually about the second, sometimes third week of May.
Oh, awesome. So we'll all be there for sure. Yeah, so anything else, Nico?
I just want to thank you guys for the opportunity to kind of talk about our film. It's personal. I think it's relevant. There's a lot of people who are going through much worse than anything I'm dealing with, but it's everyone's duty as immigrants and as people who are looking for justice to stand up for each other and tell each other stories so that we can affect some kind of change. And it's necessary change right now. So
yeah, it's reality what is happening right now. And another thing I was going to tell you, do you know when they say you live in America and people think America is just United States?
There's South America, there's Central America, there's other parts of
America. America is a whole continent.
Yeah.
America is a whole continent. Yeah. So don't forget, when you tell somebody, like, are you American? The answer is going to be yes, because they're not from, you know, Europe. Or they're, I mean, unless they're, you know, Europeans or something like that. But yeah, when you're asking somebody from Mexico or anybody from South America, you know, there are Americans. There's no, you know, when you say you're an American citizen, you mean United States, mm-hmm. American citizen? Yes, I am. You know, so don't forget that, because that is, that kind of gets me sometimes when people ask me, are you American? Like, I was born in Mexico, so I'm pretty sure I am, you know? So
yeah, and there's always like the idea that somehow if you've been here longer, you're more American, you know? That's not how this country works. The country is equal for everybody. That's how it was built. That's the point of it. That's what makes us great when we are great,
is that
we help each other and we all have the same opportunities to do great things. And you have to earn that opportunity.
Yeah.
But that's the whole point. And
we're individuals. Mm-hmm. So we're each of us work really hard for what we want. Mm-hmm. And that doesn't mean because, you know, like his family is Cuban, you know, it's like, oh, you know, he has different interests than I do. You know, we all want to be successful here, and that's why we're working really hard. I mean, college is not cheap.
No.
So if you're thinking that we just want to do this just for the fun of it, No, it's like we have a goal, and and not just us, you know, there's Chinese people that they're really into films too, all kinds of people. So if you guys would like to support, you know, the community, the film community here in Colorado is actually getting really big.
Mm-hmm.
So what we're looking is also to be like kind of like New Mexico, like Atlanta, and what's the other one big one?
Vancouver up in Canada, yeah. But all the big, we have to work with the tax incentives that we have, but Colorado has a great film community. And film speaks the language of people's souls, and that's kind of thing. It doesn't matter what you look like or what language you speak. Everyone understands film, and that's something that we're trying to foster here, and especially through our, you know, we have a great program at CU Denver. David Lieben's done a great job, so it's things to look at, and it's an art form that kind of transcends politics or whatever else, and that's what I love about it personally.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's like entertainment, I think, is universal. You know, music, films, dancing, you know, all the stuff is universal. So that is a great industry to be in that I can think of. And that's the one that people have more passion for it, because sometimes there's not a lot of money. So you're doing this because you're passionate about it. You enjoy it. So this is something that you really don't consider this work. You know, it's really nice to be on set. Doesn't matter. Sometimes it's really a lot of hours, and people don't understand that.
Yeah.
How long was that film? That scene? Oh, that scene was 2 seconds, but it took 10 hours to film.
Yeah.
They're like, how? It's like, yeah, it's not. You have to have a lot of patience. A lot of people that want to be actors and stuff like that, you know, is patience. You know, if you're not patient, then, and if you don't have a good attitude or personality, don't even try. You're gonna be hated. It's good. But yeah, anything else, guys?
No, I'm going to go watch football.
So let me see. Right now we have Danny Oliveri, the Love Doctor, saying the cuckoo is scary. Shh. I don't say that word. There's our friend Karen Pelaz. Thank you for tuning in, Karen. And we have Hello Gay Moran. Johnny. Johnny is watching us. Thank you, Johnny. Carlos Gomez, thank you. Oh, my dear. Chica Araceli, muy bien, muy buen día. Te amo. ¡Mua! Besitos a mi mami que se me fue para México. No está ahorita ahí con ella. De vacaciones, no. Johnny Johnson says, say some great music on the cell. Wish I knew how to understand Spanish, but I'm lazy American. They only understand English, and that's something not very well. That's why we're doing it bilingual, so that way, you know, everybody can get, you know, a little bit of both worlds. And usually that's what I like to have, somebody that speaks Spanish and somebody that speaks English, or, you know, somebody speak both. So that way, you know, we have all the audience, you know, understanding. And like you guys saw, we have a lot of countries here that are tuning in as well and listening to us. So thank you so much for being here with us. We'll see you soon. I mean, we have rehearsal on Wednesday.
Yep.
So people, please, if I don't answer to messages, I'm just busy doing this. So thank you. And don't forget, we're going to be sharing the information through our Facebook. And anything else?
Watch Cucuy when it comes out.
Exactly. Well, thank you for being with us. And don't forget, we'll have another Facebook Live feed at 12:15 with the Colorado Blizzards. So I'll see you guys in a little bit. Bye. Okay. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Yeah, so don't forget, well, you already sent me the link, so I'm going to start sharing it, and then my boss is going to share it. Yeah. So we're still sharing information.
That's where I pick my nose.
It's like, wait a minute.